So long in these boots, I've worn out my soul. Cut my own trail, dug my own hole. Cut my own trail, dug my own hole. I'm here for the night, where earth and sky wed. Dirt for a pillow, flame sheared my bed. Dirt for a pillow, flame sheared my bed. That's where they'll find me, ready with my gun. They've come to get me for what I have done. They've come to get me for what I have done. With guns drawn, they glitter in flame and starlight. Here to serve justice on a dark and weary night. Here to serve justice on a dark and weary night. The road is long and winding when the devil's on your back. Born and raised in a holler, they named me Crazy Jack. Born and raised in a holler, they named me Crazy Jack. Born and raised in a holler, they named me Crazy Jack.
Away from him! Run!
Crazy Jack, I reckon this guy's even crazier than you are.
Don't call me crazy! I'm just mean!
Hold your fire till you can see him! You hit nothing!
Yeah, I did. I'm sure I did.
Shut up! Look at that.
What do we do now?
Everybody, reload!
Thank you, Crazy Jack. I think I will.
I've reloaded!
Ethan, keep quiet! Quiet! When I come to him, Parsons shows himself. Let him have it with everything we got. Let's spread the word to the rest.
Hey, Parson! Why don't you show yourself so I can see what you look like up close, you crazy son of a bitch!
I know for sure I got him this time, Pa!
Shut up, Jethro!
Pa!
I said, shut up! We know this man ain't that easy to kill! Ethan!
Yeah, Crazy Jack?
Get down there and see if he's dead.
Why me?
Because I'm telling you to. Or do you want to find out just how crazy I can get? Go.
I know how crazy you can get. I've seen it. Crazy Jack! He's not here!
Don't call me crazy! Where are you, Parson? Where are you, Parson?
I'm right here.
Scatter! Get out of here!
Please, please, mister, don't kill me.
Do you believe in the good Lord?
Sure do, mister.
When you see him, ask for forgiveness. Do you believe in the good Lord?
You go to hell, mister.
I think you should go there first.
Well, looky here. Hello, Mickey. Is this your first day as the new deputy?
Close, Mr. Simpson. It's my third day. The marshal wanted to make sure I was properly trained to be a lawman before sending me out.
Well, it sure is great seeing you wearing that tin star. I'm so proud of you.
Thanks, Twitchy.
Now, don't you be calling me that. You haven't earned the right to call me that.
You have always been my favorite storekeeper, Mr. Simpson. What do I have to do to get to calling you Twitchy?
Well, whatever it is, it's more than wearing that badge.
Oh, come now, Mr. Simpson. Everybody calls you Twitchy.
Everyone over 40, and you ain't over 40.
So I've got to wait about 20 years to call a man I've known my whole life by his first name.
That's about right. And don't you forget it.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I've just seen someone who won't mind me calling them by their first name.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'll see you later, Mickey.
Good day to you, Miss Parker.
Oh my, look who's all pleased with himself because he's the new deputy in town.
I'm just out getting to know the good people of Tranquility and letting them know who the new deputy marshal is around here, of course.
Hi, Mickey Garrett. You've lived here your whole life. Everybody knows you. And you know everyone in Tranquilities anyway.
Well, there is one person I would like to know better.
Who would that be? Mickey Garrett, don't you think you can charm me just because you're the new lawman in town?
Molly Parker, I was thinking of asking you out to the church social next Saturday.
Well, that's different. I don't know if my mom and pa would allow it.
I am now a respectable pillar of society in Tranquility, Miss Parker. I don't see how your parents could possibly refuse.
You took my whiskey!
You took my whiskey!
Harry, you idiot, you took my whiskey!
You would say that! You took it when I wasn't looking!
Took nothing!
Excuse me, Miss Parker, looks like I have to go and break up the Henderson boys' little spat.
Break it up, boys! Come on, boys, that's enough! Break it up!
What was that noise?
It's just Mickey Garrett.
I warned you!
What are you doing there? bad for, Mickey! We was just fine.
You were disturbing the peace. Now get up to the jail.
Why are we going to jail?
Because you are under arrest.
You can't arrest us.
I can, and I did. I'm the new deputy marshal. Deputy marshal? Oh man, when did that happen? Get up to the jail and I'll tell you all about it. Pa! Pa, do you think we lost him?
Well, I think we lost him for now.
What if he picks up the trail again? I'm awful scared, Pa.
There ain't no son of mine gonna admit he's scared of any man.
I don't think he's a man, Pa. I think he's...
He's what?
I think he's the devil.
Jethro, you dumbass! He's just a normal man like any other man!
But he keeps picking up our trail. We've tried everything to shake him. He's killed my brother and now he's killed the rest of the boys.
Yeah. Well, he's a mite good at killing, that's for sure. Where you been? I thought you was dead!
I would have been no thanks to you!
Don't you get on my bad side! I ain't in the mood! Now where's the rest of the boys?
Where do you think? They're heading for Boot Hill!
Are they all dead?
That murdering parson gunned them all down. Finished them off at close range.
He must be the devil, Pa. I've only seen you do that a couple of times.
Oh, shut up, Jethro! How could a father a son as dumb as you?
I reckon we best get moving along.
Why? I'm getting a mighty tired of running.
Well, you left a trail a blind man could follow. How do you think I found you? That parson's not going to be too far behind.
Where are we going to go?
This might sound like a crazy idea.
What?
I reckon we should make tracks to Tranquility.
What do we want to go there for?
Because we need some protection from the law.
The law? That is crazy. Why would the law protect us?
Because we're all going to be dead men if we try to take that parson on by ourselves. And I ain't that crazy!
How far away is Tranquility, Pa?
We can get there in a few days.
What if the law doesn't want to protect us? Said they just want to put us in jail, huh? Did you think about that?
Well, yeah. But that's the real crazy part of it. Because if we can't get the lawman's guns to help us, then we'll set up an ambush in the town for that parson. Let's move.
Sorry about the trouble we caused, Deputy Garrett.
Sure are, sir. Won't happen again. Okay, boys, off you go.
Stay out of trouble.
Don't worry about us, Deputy Garrett.
Won't happen again. Hey, I need a whiskey.
Good morning, Deputy Garrett.
It is now that you showed up, Miss Parker.
I'm mightily impressed that you're in charge of the jail here.
I will be, for a while. The marshal has had to leave town and so left me in charge. He said I was to look after things here.
Well, I guess the marshal has a lot of confidence in his new deputy. Why has he left town?
We got word that a man was found dead, shot to death, next to Indian Mountain.
That sounds dreadful.
It probably is, but it does mean I can show you my jailhouse.
I can't go into a jailhouse. I have my reputation to think about.
So why are you parading around here, Miss Parker?
Well, I thought that you might like to know that I've thought over your invitation.
My invitation?
Don't you go joshing me, Deputy Mickey Garrett. I've had a very serious talk with my mom, Pa, and they have given permission for you to take me to the church social on Saturday.
Well, I'm mighty pleased you have consented to be taken to the church social, Miss Molly Parker.
Well, I guess that concludes my business here at the jailhouse. I'll see you on Saturday.
Barkeeper, give me some whiskey for me and my boys.
Have you got money to pay for this?
Don't give me that, barkeeper. I want whiskey and I want it now. Or so help me, I will rip your innards out!
Okay, mister.
Yeah, barkeep. We've had a real bad few days. We could do with a drink.
Get my mom gingham or just calico?
Well, now, Molly, you know that good cotton is kind of hard to find just now. But I have a catalog. If you're okay to have a look.
Hey, Twitchy, you never guess who I just saw going in the saloon.
Well, who'd you see, Gritty?
It's that Crazy Jack bookbinder and a couple of his boys. And I'll come get the marshal.
The marshal's out of town. The only law we've got is the new deputy.
I'll go and get him then.
You can't do that. If he goes in there alone, Crazy Jack will kill him just for stepping in his shadow.
But he's the lawman round here.
Well, he'll be a dead lawman if he goes in there alone. I saw that boy grow up, and I'm not going to see him gunned down.
Mickey's brave enough to take on these fellas.
It's not a matter of being brave enough or stupid enough. If he goes in there to arrest them, they'll kill him, and that's a fact.
You've got to do something. What about the folks in the saloon?
She's right. What I heard down that saloon wasn't pretty.
Molly, you go up. See the deputy. Try and keep him distracted from going down to the saloon.
How do I do that?
You know he's sweet on you. Just go up and see him. That should be enough. Gritty, you're coming with me.
Nice to see a minister in Tranquility. I didn't know you were coming. Have you come to take over at the church? We only have a lay preacher at the moment, and he's quite good.
But there's nothing like a real proper ordained minister to lead us out. Well, I'm just travelling through Tranquility. We do have a lovely little mission hall just down the road from here, where you could read from the good book. It'll be so good to have a parson like yourself leading the prayers.
Excuse me, ma'am. You don't want me as your parson.
Whiskey, you slimy weasel.
You're out of line, mister!
Don't tell me what I am and what I ain't, you pasty-faced hog. More whiskey.
Just you folks, sit down!
Or what?
Or I'll shoot you where you stand. I might just do it anyway, for the fun of it.
Can't talk to my brother like that.
Sit down, fella. He means it. He likes killing.
Let me tell you all who I am. I was given the name of Jacob Bookbinder, but I changed that name to become Jack. Better known as Crazy Jack! Do you know me? Do you know me? Do you?
I heard of you.
Crazy Jack, are you sure you want to be doing this?
You're right, Ethan. But quit calling me crazy!
Okay, Jack. But we came here looking for the marshal. Not to pick fights with the town folk.
Yeah, you're a good man, Ethan. What would I do without you?
Karen.
You! You don't! stinking ox!
What is it, Pa?
Not you! You! Where's the marshal in this town?
He's rode out this morning.
Why? Did he hear I was coming?
No. No, he went to check out a killing over at Indian Mountain.
Indian Mountain? That's where we just came from.
I don't believe this is happening! God damn it! I ain't gonna last another day in this place!
You seem a little troubled then, mister.
You got that right! What's it gotta do with you anyway? Do you think I'm crazy?
No. No. I see you're kind of angry at everyone. Is there something I can do to help?
I don't think so. What's the matter with you?
Nothing. Just something I was left with after the war.
Yeah. Well, you were lucky.
I guess I was. If I hear right, you're looking for the marshal.
Are you the marshal?
No. He's...
I'm the storekeeper. You fellas look like you've ridden a long way.
Yeah? What of it?
Well, the marshal ain't gonna be back anytime soon, so why don't you sit down, relax, and I can get some food from my store.
What are you up to, storekeeper?
I don't want to see anyone hurt. I'll get word to the marshal that you're looking for him. Meanwhile, I'll get some jars of peaches, and one of the ladies can cook you up a nice steak.
That sounds pretty good to me, Pa.
All you people, get out of here! All of you, get out of here! No! Because I need protecting.
Anything you say, sir. I'll get one of the Henderson boys to ride out after the marshal and get these gunslingers some food. I've just bought us some more time. Now you get in there and keep them talking.
You want me to keep them talking?
We need to buy more time.
Hello, Twitchy.
Stuart Cranson?
That's me.
I don't believe it. I never expected to see you again after the Civil War.
I don't have time for small talk.
What brings you here, Reverend?
I need bullets. I've run out, and I'm not a reverend anymore.
Oh, yeah, I heard you got yourself quite a reputation after the last 2 years.
So I heard.
They calling you the Devil's Parson.
That's about right. Give me 2 boxes of shells. That should be enough.
Enough? Enough for what?
I've just about finished my work. I'm going to shoot those murdering snakes that killed my boy and everyone at that farm.
Oh, yeah, Stuart, I heard what they did to your family.
Did you? You have no idea. I thought I'd seen and heard it all when I was the army chaplain during the war.
Yeah, we all saw a lot.
Give me those bullets, Twitchy.
Is more killing the answer?
It is for me. The world's gonna be a better place when I kill Crazy Jack Bookbinder and his gang.
So it's Crazy Jack? He's...
In the saloon. I know. I chased him there.
Look, Stuart. If
you go in and start shooting, you're going to get the deputy marshal down there.
So?
He's just a green kid. He couldn't take on all you gunmen. I've been trying to keep him away from Crazy Jack Bookbinder, and now you show up.
As long as he doesn't get in my way, he's got nothing to worry about. Now give me those shells.
So the horse, he ups and kicked that mule right back.
You is the slowest talker I have ever met.
Can I just kill him, Pa? I ain't killed nobody in 3 months.
Is that all you think about, Jethro? There's a maniac out there and he's chasing after us. And all you can think about is shooting this dumb old goat?
Well, I was thinking about shooting him myself!
I thought you guys came to this town for help.
Let's face it, Gritty. That is your name, ain't it?
That's what they call me. Gritty Tumbleweed.
We ain't getting no help here. And that storekeeper? Well, he's planning something. I don't know what. But I'll tell you, I was in the war between the states, and I saw an awful lot of killing. And I kind of got a taste for it. Now, I'm thinking, it's just us.
Just you and me, Jack?
Damn, man! I ain't finished talking yet! Now, I've been chased all over this country by an unstoppable gun-toting parson. He's killed one of my boys. He's killed all of my men. And he's hunted me down like I'm some kind of wild animal! Now, I'm tired. I've never been so thirsty or so hungry in my entire life. Now I'm stuck here listening to some old fool croaking on a bit more stupid old horses and mules.
Where's those steaks we've been promised?
I'll find out right away.
She reckon this is it then, Jack?
Yep.
What does he mean, Pa?
That parson's gonna come through that door soon. And when he does, it's either him or us.
What if it's us, Pa?
Jethro, son, you are so dumb. If you get killed, you and nobody else would even know the difference.
Molly, did I say I was surprised that you took up my invitation to visit this fine town jail?
You sure did, Deputy Garrett.
What changed your mind so soon after turning me down?
It's a woman's privilege to change her mind.
Why, sure it is. You're not worried about your reputation anymore? You know how people talk.
There are some things more important than reputations.
Like what?
Oh, keeping safe the things you care about?
What's that supposed to mean?
Mickey, why'd you ask so many questions? Can't you just be happy I came to see you?
Why, sure I am. But, you know, you have been kind of strange ever since you came in here.
I've never been in a jailhouse before.
It's not that. You seem a little worried about something. Something else?
What if I am?
Is it something I can help you with?
No. I mean, yes.
Well, what is it?
I just want you to stay here with me.
You know, I think I'm going to have to take another walk around the town. Make sure everything is tranquil in Tranquility.
You can just stay here.
Miss Parker, I have my duties to carry out. I take up holding the law in this town very seriously.
Well, just shut up and drink your coffee then, and make sure you finish it.
Got enough guns there, Parson?
If I finish my job today, I won't need guns no more.
Gunfighters like you never finish. There's always one more victim.
I only killed the people I set out to kill. I didn't kill anyone that didn't need killing.
How do you know they needed killing?
Because every one of them was one of Crazy Jack Bookbinder's gang. And every one of them killed every one of my family in that farm. Or they was someone trying to kill me.
He's coming.
How do you want to play this?
Ethan, get over the right-hand side of that door. Jethro, get down behind the bar. I'll sit here and be his target when he comes through that door. And then you can both shoot him in the back.
You sure about this, Jack? You never make yourself a target.
Do you really want to argue about this now, Ethan?
I have to check the town.
No, you don't.
So this is what you look like close up?
Yeah.
And you're the one they call the Devil's Parson?
Yeah.
Well, come on in, Devil's Parson. Let's talk about this.
No.
They say I've done a lot of bad things in my time.
They'd be right.
But I never attacked no church, so why are you chasing after me and my boys?
2 years ago, you burned down farmhouse up near the Montana border.
Yeah? Well, I burned down plenty of farmhouses in my time.
This one had my son, his wife, and my grandkids in it.
Oh, yeah. I remember that one. They made such a beautiful noise!
That's gunfire. Looks like it's down at the saloon.
Don't go.
What are you doing? Get out of the way.
Don't go, Mickey.
Good and dead. Drop your guns and put your hands up.
You'll get no trouble from me, deputy. Take me away and hang me.
I think we'll head right up to the jail. The hanging will come a while later, after your trial. Now move!
Well, don't that beat all.
Honest, Mickey. Twitchy, was already trying to stop you getting shot.
So you all planned it together to make sure I couldn't do my job.
It was Twitchy's idea, not that I wanted you to get shot. I was quite prepared to let you go up there and face Crazy Jack on your own. Not that, but I'm glad you're not dead.
Molly Parker, I need to have a word with you.
What about Mickey Garrett?
You know what about. This whole world is turned upside down.
What do you mean?
I'm the deputy marshal in this town. I'm supposed to protect the people here, not the other way around.
We all know that, Mickey. We all want to make sure you stay alive long enough to look after us all.
There were three dangerous outlaws in the saloon, and you stopped me going to arrest them?
I stopped you getting your head blown off by them, you mean.
So you think I ain't man enough to be a lawman? Did you think I didn't have the guts to go up against Crazy Jack and his men? Did you? What sort of man do you think I am?
Deputy Marshal Mickey Garrett, you're the best man I know. You're the sweetest, kindest man I have ever met, and yes, you're without doubt the bravest man I could ever meet. But you ain't got a lick of sense. I saw you charging into that saloon and I thought you were a goner for sure. What woman in her right mind would want to lose a man like that? And if you can't see how the people in this town feel about you, then you're a bigger fool than I thought you were.
You're one hell of a lawman, Deputy.
What do you mean?
You just got made deputy a few days ago. Got left in charge of this whole town. Biggest gang of desperados in the territory arrive, start causing all sorts of trouble. Then this fearsome fella called the Devil's Parsons shows up.
I know that. What's your point?
My point, Deputy, is all of Crazy Jack's gang is laying out there dead. I'm locked up in here. No innocent bystanders got hurt, and you barely had to lift a finger to do it. You're one hell of a lawman, Deputy.
What?
Hi there, Amos. Did you find the marshal?
That's just the thing, Twitchy. Tell him, Amos.
I found the marshal. He was dead.
Dead? What happened?
I found him at the side of the trail. Looked to me like he was shot in the back.
Who would do such a thing?
I think it might have been these fellers that gave me this note.
As you can see, your marshal is dead. Everyone in Tranquility will be dead unless they leave town by noon on Friday. That's tomorrow. Leave your money and valuables in the town, or we will catch up with you on the trail and slaughter you all. If you stay in the town, we will slaughter you all. It's signed Major Jericho.
It looks like they mean to rob the whole town.
Amos, how many men did that colonel fella have with him?
I don't know. There was more than I could count.
Amos, you don't know how to count.
That ain't my fault. It's my brother Aaron that does the counting.
Amos, have you told Mickey about this?
No, we thought we'd better tell you first.
I'm just a storekeeper. Mickey will be the new marshal now. Now, we better go and warn him, but first we'll go to the telegraph office and send a message for help. Come on.
If you don't mind my asking, how did a preacher like you become the Devil's Parson?
Like me? What you hear?
Not much. Just that you were a preacher who turned to gunfighting?
That's my story. You heard it.
It's not exactly something a God-fearing man would do.
A God-fearing man? No.
But I don't fear God. I don't believe in God. I'm not afraid of death. So just take me out and hang me. Get it over with.
You are without a doubt the strangest man I ever met.
A parson who doesn't believe in God.
I used to believe in the Almighty. I had a church of my own and a big congregation.
What went wrong?
It was the Civil War that started it. I joined a New York infantry regiment as a chaplain. Went off to war. Saw men getting dragged off the battlefield. A terrible sight, son. A terrible sight. Some were just boys, younger than you. But that still never shook the faith in the Almighty. Oh no. We were still doing the Lord's work. We were fighting for the Union.
I heard it was bad.
I often went to the surgeon's tent to give comfort to the dying. That was my job. They'd be dragged in there screaming, put on that surgeon's table. And pretty quick he'd cut off hands and feet and arms and legs. Looking at and walking past that pile of limbs laying at the end of the tent, that never shook my faith in the Almighty. We were so righteous. I thought nothing could shake my faith. Not even my wife dying of smallpox a few years back.
What did shake it?
The war started it, but about 2 years ago, I was setting up a mission hall on the outskirts of a small town near the Montana border. My son, his wife, and a few others were in a small farm across the valley. First I knew there was anything wrong was when I heard gunfire. And I looked across and the farm was afire. Strange, but even at that distance I could hear the screams of the little ones. I got there as fast as I could. It didn't matter how hard I whipped my horse to gallop faster. I was too late. All the way there, I prayed to God that he would save their lives. But he didn't. He let Crazy Jack Bookbinder burn them all to death in that farmhouse. Last thing I saw was my son's dog. Crazy Jack Bookbinder and his gang had broke its back legs and the dog was crying for help. I had to shoot that dog. Where was God then?
That's a tragic story, Parson.
I ain't no parson. I gave up being a parson. I spent the last 2 years hunting down and killing Crazy Jack Bookbinder and his gang. I finished that job yesterday. Now I need to be hung for my sins.
From what you say, it sounds like all you did was kill a bunch of outlaws.
That's what I did do.
You took the law into your own hands, but I don't think you should hang for it.
You'd be doing me a favor.
We don't hang folks for a favor, Parson.
We got some real bad news, Mickey. The marshal's dead. And then take a look at this note.
Well, what you doing pacing up and down here, Mr. Parker?
We were just thinking.
You're thinking about Mickey, ain't you?
He thinks I betrayed him or something. I was just trying to save his life.
Oh, he'll soon see sense. Soon enough. Soon as he climbs down from that high horse and puts his pride back in the box.
You really think so, Gertie?
Of course I do. Yeah, I ain't some dumb old fool who just fixes wagons, you know. Give it time, Missy.
Thanks, Gertie.
We don't know how many men are in this gang, but we better telegraph Fort Maxwell for help right away.
We've just come from the telegraph office. The lines have been cut!
What? That means the attack has already started.
What are we gonna do, Mickey?
We can't have no bunch of outlaws chasing us out of our own town. I say we stand and fight.
I'll go get my brother Aaron.
Who is this Major Jericho?
I don't know.
I've never heard of him.
I know him.
You know him?
I traveled all over this country chasing Crazy Jack and his gang. Down in Arizona, I ran into this Major Jericho and his outfit. To begin with, I thought it was Crazy Jack. They seemed just as bad. I killed two of them before I realized my mistake.
That's some mistake.
That's the way of it. They got in my way, I moved on.
What about this note? Will he attack the town?
It's what he does. He finds quiet, out-of-the-way places and clears them out. Sounds like he's found his way up here.
Take it to go find a note, Deputy.
I got your note. Leave that girl alone.
No harm will come to her as long as you follow instructions. She's my little insurance policy.
You snake. I will kill you.
Deputy, you're in no position to talk to me like that. I'm trying to save lives by getting you all out of town.
You can't do that.
My men are all around this town. I think you'll find that I can do this. There are a lot of women and children. You don't want them getting hit when the lead starts flying. All of you get out of town by noon. Or the first one that gets it will be that girl.
Twitchy, start evacuating the town.
About that girl.
I have done nothing but think about her.
You know they're going to kill her.
I don't know that. You don't know that.
And once they've taken everything of value out of Tranquility, they will burn it to the ground and then chase the people down the road and have some fun with them.
What could I do? I had to send them away.
You're between a rock and a hard place. At least out of town, they might live.
I have to get Molly back. I have to wait here to see her.
Or you could let me out.
You'd help me?
You're a good young fella. And I hate scum like Jericho. I want you to start at the town hall and do a fighting retreat back up to the jailhouse. Jericho and his men will come from down there. I just know it.
What about Molly?
She'll either be at the rear or she'll be in the trees over there. Either way, I'll get her back.
I hope you're right, Parson.
there, Jericho.
I see you're still here, Deputy.
Where's the girl, Jericho?
Just back there.
Thank you, Deputy. Now I know where she is.
You got everything you wanted. Now let the girl go.
I'll consider letting her go once you drop your gun belt.
Give up my gun to you? That ain't happening, Jericho.
This deputy's playing for time. Just shoot him!
Take this six shooter. You might need it yet. Come on.
You're one hell of a lawman, Deputy.
I couldn't have done it without you, Parson.
I just did some shooting. You stood up and saved the town. And you got a girl to stand with you. You're one hell of a lawman, Deputy.
Molly, you are incredible. If you weren't a woman, I'd as soon as have you as my deputy.
Why, Mickey Garrett, before you go making anyone your deputy, you promised something very important.
What's that, Molly?
Take me to the church social.
Parson, or perhaps I should say Stuart Cranston, I feel I sort of owe you, so why don't we say that during all the turmoil, you got away.
Much obliged, Deputy. Miss Parker.
I guess we better get the townsfolk back to Tranquility. It seems pretty tranquil now.
Much obliged, Deputy. Miss Parker.
Thank you.
horse, he up and kicked that mule again.
Was that, sorry, was that, I thought it was more to your line. Was that, can't face it, Gritty. That is your name, isn't it, Gritty?
Yeah, Gritty. I forgot my second name.
Tumbleweed.
Gritty Tumbleweed.
Tumbleweed, yeah, that's it. Gritty Tumbleweed, yeah.
Have you got a gun? Have you got enough guns there, Pardon?
Or there was someone trying to kill me.
How do you know they needed killing?
And I think I just got that wrong way around.
Yes. How do you know they needed killing?
Or was someone who said I was to kill him? I knew that was going to happen sooner or later.
Can you get my mom getting Orange's Calico? Sorry. Can you get my mom gingham or just calico?
Now, Molly, you know that good cotton is kind of hard to come by just now.
Action!
Hello, Twitchy.
Action. I don't have time for small talk.
What brings you here, Reverend?
I've run out of bullets. And that's complete bollocks.
I'll just say it again.
I want bullets.
I want bullets. I've run out. And I'm not a reverend anymore.
No, he's not. You haven't run out. Is it?
Mm-hmm. That's right, there.
I beg your pardon. Sorry. Okay, Gordon, back to you.
Just calico.
Well, Molly, you know, good cotton is kind of hard to find. I've heard about... Stuart, yeah. He goes down there. He couldn't take on all you gunmen. I've been trying for years to keep him away from Crazy Jack.
No, you haven't.
I've been trying.
Not for years.
Not for years.
Where'd I get that from?
As long as he doesn't get in my way, he's got nothing to worry about. Now give me those bullets, shit.
Dragon.
Did he call me? Did he call me what I thought he called me?
Sorry, I think I did, actually. Sorry about that.
Action.
Cut.
From where?
I think I got him, Pa.
Shut up, Ian. You ain't nothing.
I did. I'm sure I did.
Ian, you... Jethro.
I was gonna say, I'm just gonna keep going. I think I got him, Pa!
Shut up!
Gonna call Meetham again.
I think I got him, Pa!
Shut up, Jethro! You hit nothing!
I did, I'm sure I did!
Jethro, you dumb son of a bitch!
No, I can't say that, can I?
I know for sure I got him this time, Pa!
Shut up, you...
I know for sure I got it this time, Pa!
Shut up, Ethan!
I am Jethro, goddammit! You're as dumb as I am!
Well, that wouldn't be hard! I will rip your ears out!
Okay, okay! Mister! Okay, okay, mister!
Where's the marshal in this town?
You rode out this morning.
What is it, Pa?
No, not you! You! Where's the marshal in it?
This way.
Not you! You! Where's the marshal in this town?
I'm sorry.
Camera rolling. Action. Cut! Oi!
Ruthless, fire! Normal Jack, fire! Somebody fire! Cut!
You stood up and saved the town. And you got a girl to stand with you.
Bollocks!
That was. Oh my, this is all pleased with himself to do when he gets to Game Town.
Cut. Let's take it from the top. And action!
Which top? You start?
Which top, sorry?
We'd better go and warn him, but first we'll go to the telegram.
What could I do? I had to send them away.
He'll be all right. He'll calm down. No. Let you get shot. Not that it mattered to me. I was quite prepared for you to go up and face old crazy Jack, on your own. Not really.
Well, don't that beat all.
Well, it's the honest truth, Mickey.
Just get the leg.
Twitchy just didn't want you to get shot.